Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see how the FETs get classified and how it is constructed. So let's begin with the topic. Now we know that FET is considered as one of the most important semiconductor device that can be used after BJT. But as compared to BJT, FET having many advantages, like it has better thermal stability, it produces less noise, it has high input impedance, and it can be used at high frequency. So because of these advantages of FET, the FET is preferred over BJT in many of the applications like integrated circuit, digital switch, amplifiers, and amplitude modulation. Now let's see how the FET is get classified. Now we know that FET also consists of a semiconductor material. So on the basis of the semiconductor material, the FET is get classified into two types. First one is junction field effect transistor and other is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Now based on which type of semiconductor material is used as a channel medium, the JFET is further get classified into two types, that is N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET. Whereas MOSFET is get classified into depletion MOSFET and enhancement MOSFET. Further, the depletion and enhancement MOSFET get classified into N-channel and P-channel respectively. Now let's see the JFET, how N-channel and P-channel JFET is get constructed. N-channel JFET, as its name indicate, it consists of N-channel. Based on which type of material or channel used for the construction of junction field effect transistor, the JFETs get classified into two types. The first one is N-channel JFET. As its name indicates, it consists of channel as a N-type semiconducting material. Now let's see the construction first. As we know, FET consists of three terminal, drain, gate and source. Now moving towards the construction of N-channel JFET. So it consists of N-type semiconducting bar and two heavily doped P region. On both sides of N-type semiconducting bar, two heavily doped P region are deployed or diffuse or alloy in order to create two PN junctions. The space between the junction, that means the N-type semiconducting bar, is called as channel. Now in this case, the channel is used as N-type, therefore whatever current flows through the JFET is because of the majority carrier, that means electron. Now internally, the two P channels are connected and single wire is taken out to form a terminal called as drain gate terminal. On both the side of semiconducting bar, two terminals are taken out in the form of electrical contact, which are also called as ohmic contact, and they are named as drain terminal and source terminal. The drain terminal is present on upper side, whereas source terminal is present on lower side. Now whenever the gate to source voltage is applied to FET, the drain current starts flowing from drain to source terminal. So the direction of current is always opposite to the flow of electron. Therefore, because of this, the drain terminal through which electron leaves the FET and source terminal through which electron enters the FET. As the semiconducting bar used here is a N-type semiconducting material, therefore the electron flows only because of the majority carrier, that means electron. Therefore, FET is used as a unipolar device. Now moving towards the symbol of N-channel JFET. So the vertical line in symbol is called as channel and an arrowhead present on gate direct towards the channel. Now let's see the construction of P-channel JFET. Similar to N-channel JFET, P-channel JFET also consists of semiconducting material bar, but now in this case the semiconducting bar is made up of P-type semiconducting material and it consists of two heavily doped N-type semiconducting regions. On both the side of P-type semiconducting bar, two heavily doped N-type regions are diffused or alloy in order to create a 2PN junction. The space between the junction is called as channel. So now in this case, as the semiconducting bar is P-type, therefore it is called as P-channel JFET. Internally, both the N regions are connected together and a single wire is taken out to create a terminal called as gate. Ohmic contacts are made on both the sides of the P-type semiconducting bar in order to form a terminal called as drain and source terminal. Now in this case, the semiconducting bar used here is P-type. Therefore, whatever current flows through JFET is because of the majority carrier, that means electron. And therefore, the JFET is called as unipolar device. Now moving towards the symbol of P-channel JFET, the vertical line represents channel, whereas now in this case the arrowhead present on gate point opposite to the channel, whereas in case of N-channel JFET, the arrowhead point towards the channel. So this is how the N-channel and P-channel JFET is get constructed and classification of FET. So I hope you understand this video. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.